Hello and welcome to Sarah's Tarot. Here is your weekly card pick for week beginning Monday the 1st of October with regard to your love life for the week ahead. This week I have the Romance Angels deck and the Loving Heart Oracle. And if you focus your eyes on the three sets of cards in front of you, 1, 2 and 3, and decide which you feel drawn to, I'll then turn the cards over and we'll take a look at your messages for the week ahead. Okay, so those of you who are drawn to set one, you have the card Barriers and Free Yourself. Okay, so if you're in a relationship, then the angels want you to take a look at where you need to take back some control. Where is it that you are feeling trapped or stuck? Do you have an overbearing partner? Is he or she controlling? Or are you imposing limits upon yourself? Do you feel as if you want to do more, but for some reason you're holding yourself back? Whatever the case is, you're being urged to free yourself from these limitations, to let down these barriers that you or your partner have put up, and realize that you can take back control. You can step forward and do the things you want, even though you are with someone. It doesn't mean you can't have your own life. And if your partner is preventing you, then it may be time to speak up and have your voice heard. This could also be with regard to commitment. Maybe someone wants more commitment from you, or you want more commitment from them, and you feel that there are barriers to going forward and barriers that are preventing this relationship from growing, from flourishing. So this is about being honest with yourself and realizing that it's time to start following your own heart and taking care of your own needs and realizing you don't need to be stuck if you don't want to. And for those of you who are not in a relationship, you're being urged to ask yourself, have you been putting barriers up and preventing a partner or a special person from entering your life? Sometimes we can be hurt, and you know, that can lead to us building walls around ourselves, putting ourselves in a cocoon, perhaps making excuses as well. You know, we can't be in a relationship now because of this and because of that. You know, you might say you work too hard, you know, there's no time, etc., etc. If that's the case, think about whether they are self-imposed limitations designed to prevent a partner coming in simply because you're afraid of being hurt or of failure or of that kind of thing. If that's the case, try and let some of these barriers down this week, especially if you are going on a date of some kind. You know, free yourself and take control of your relationship destiny. And they are card set one. Okay, and so set two is the Peace card and Forgiving and Learning. As you release and heal the past, you experience more love in your present moments. And that is, of course, when you find peace. So for those of you in a relationship, this is about you forgiving the past. This could be with relation to a past relationship, or an existing one, the one that you're in now. Whichever it is, holding on to grudges prevents you from fully opening your heart and fully being present in this relationship now. So by learning to forgive and forget, you open the door to more intimacy and a more deeper love between you and your partner. This card also urges you to take time to truly heal, to not be so hard on yourself or others for whatever has gone on in the past. If it's you and your existing partner that have had your ups and downs, then realise that that happens to us all. No relationship is perfect, but we can learn so much from our heartbreaks, from our disagreements. And with that, we can grow and our relationship can flourish. And you can do that too if you let go of whatever you've been holding in your heart and step forward and realize that all relationships are, you know, deserve a second chance. And just learn from whatever went on. And for those of you who are not in a relationship, then this is about finding a way to let go of whatever is holding you back right now. Maybe you're holding on to these past issues so tightly that you're scared of entering into anything new. It's about finding the peace inside you this week. And by forgiving, you can do that. You can really get to a point where, you know, you realise that certain things happened for a reason. And learn from that. Learn from those past experiences, those past mistakes. Whether you feel it was your fault or your ex-partner's fault, don't allow that to prevent your future happiness. And start taking steps this week to just let go. And for those of you drawn to cards 3, then we have the Spark card and Make the Effort. Okay. Great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take. So, for those of you in a relationship, this is about you continuing to make the effort. Not just yourself, but your partner, of course. You know, we can get into a relationship and become quite complacent and get into a bit of a rut sometimes. If you feel this is the case for you at the moment, then you're being urged to bring back that spark that may be missing and to look at what you can do to achieve that. Maybe you need to pamper your partner a bit more. Make them feel special, make them feel loved and cherished, and in return, they need to do the same for you. Because it's only through constant effort that relationships are successful. And if you're feeling as if things are a little bit perhaps dull at the moment, or you know, nothing much is happening between you and it's the same old, then it could be time now, particularly this week, to just do whatever ignites your fire and that of your partner's. You know, bring that spark back in. Just by making some extra effort, you can really change things up for the two of you. And for those of you who are not in a relationship, then these cards are suggesting that you need to look at whether you are, in fact, making enough effort to find somebody, or have you kind of become despondent and decided that it's really not worth the effort. If so, then the angels want you to know it is worth the effort. You can bring Mr. or Mrs. Right into your life, but you do need to work hard at achieving this, okay? So, you know, it's about putting yourself out there, really, whether it's through a dating site, friends, you know, getting out with and being in the world where you may meet people, meet potential partners, making an effort with your appearance, all that kind of thing, and bringing some spark back into your life. That's what the angels want you to know for this week ahead. You can do it. It's often a matter of perspective and a change of attitude. Okay, so they are your cards for this week. If you would like to take a deeper look at your relationship, your the love area of your life, then you can order a reading from me by going to the link below. Wishing you a wonderful week. Much love to you all.